The National Museum of African American History and Culture opened in 2016. We were created to collect and interpret African American history and culture. And one of the primary ways that we do that is through objects. Objects are our lifeline to history, and we really are always looking for ways to draw out those details and share them with the public.
Museums tell stories. They share information of the world in the form of story. Technology is an instrument that can open up stories that people have never heard before. A few years back, the museum's leadership came to Google and just asked the Black Googler Network to help bring the museum into the modern age. That kind of started it. The Black Googler Network's purpose is to showcase how the Black community influences the tech ecosystem. A part of the way in which we do this is by sharing stories, and that intersection really paired well with a collaboration with the museum space. Google had developed this 3D camera rig for other commercial purposes, but I realized that we could use this rig in the context of a museum.
What we've got is a fully automated, fully contained system that has all of the parts to capture all of the images that it needs for a scan and to process all of those images into a full virtual model of an object. So this system incorporates 9 cameras. 3 of them are normal DSLRs that capture full color, and 6 of them are machine cameras that are specially set up to look stereoscopically at the pattern of light that's projected onto the objects. In a matter of about 3 minutes, it captures all of that information that we need. The computer software processing is also extraordinarily complicated. It interprets the shapes and the colors into a full 3-dimensional geometry with color on that surface. What we get out of these machines is a full virtual model. That means you can manipulate the model. You can turn it from any direction to look at the little details. You can zoom in and out to see the texture of the surfaces. And this system can capture all of those angles in a single process. So we've gone from what was a process of days with a whole team of people to now having a single operator that can put an object in every 3 to 4 minutes and get virtual models out the other end with no other interaction.
The scanning pilot project, we selected about 30 objects to scan, and then out of those 30, we picked 10 to feature in the interactive. We've created an interactive kiosk where visitors can approach this large wall, and so we've made the objects much larger than life. And then we have a joystick and a trackpad that people can use to manipulate the objects. So you can rotate them, you can zoom in and out, and then you can also explore the object to find the different stories that are connected to different details. Once we've moved our objects from the physical to the digital realm, the possibilities are really endless.
We can put those onto the website, can download these files, they can make 3D prints of the files, they can use them in lesson plans, they can use them for research. So many options open up for having that digital model.
One of the main benefits for all of this is just being able to share more of the world's knowledge with future generations to come. The possibilities are boundless. You just have to have the creativity to figure out what you want to do with them.